and welcome to Don't Miss. I'm Norman Mark, and on this show, we're going to take you to a children's museum where the whole family can have fun and learn something at the same time. And what could be more Irish than shamrocks, than corned beef and cabbage, than the Blarney Stone? Irish dancers, of course, and we're going to take a look. But first, Mary Tyler Moore and Cheer star Ted Danson team up in a movie, Just Between Friends. It opens this Friday. It's the story of the friendship between Holly Davis and Sandy Dunlap, who couldn't be more different. Holly, played by Mary Tyler Moore, is a shy homemaker happily married to Ted Danson. Christine Lahti, who plays Sandy, is a divorced TV journalist. Their friendship is tested when Holly discovers Sandy has been more than a friend to her husband.
No, I'm glad you didn't. It was so much better to find out this way.
Holly, I didn't know you when I met him. If I had, this never would have happened. You've got to believe me.
It's all right, as long as you don't know the wife. Is that what you're saying?
No, of course not. But as soon as I realized what the situation was, I ended it. That's the truth, Holly.
Am I supposed to thank you or something?
Look, we really can't talk about this here.
I'm going to pay you back. Every penny. I don't want your guilt money.
It wasn't that, Holly. I really wanted to help you. I love you. I just wanted to be your friend.
Incidentally, the journalist helped Mary Tyler Moore by giving her $8,000 to start a gym. Now, I'm going to have a review of Just Between Friends next week. Gung Ho opened on Friday. It stars Michael Keaton. Now, you may remember him as Mr. Mom.
Look, my men are expecting a raise.
In the film, competition from foreign automakers has hit Hadleyville, Pennsylvania very hard. For years, the town's major industry has been its local auto factory, but the plant is shut down and the townspeople are leaving as fast as they can. All is not lost. Hunt Stevenson, played by Michael Keaton, once a foreman with the auto plant, flies to Tokyo and persuades a Japanese automaker to take over the factory. He becomes an overnight hero, but neither Hadleyville or the executives of Asan Motors are prepared for what happens next.
You told me that you could control your men. You put me in a very bad situation.
Hey, look, hotshot, I bailed you out I don't know how many times. Who do you think kept the guys going this long? You and all that personal charm of yours. It was me. I backed you. I handed you 14,000 cars. And now I'm going to look like give my men a raise.
Are you crazy? If I give them a raise, Mr. Sakamoto would have a baby. Working conditions must remain as they are. You tell them that.
With his film Splash, Night Shift, and Cocoon, Ron Howard, formerly Opie, Little Opie on the Andy Griffith TV show, proved that he knew how to direct comedy. Now he's trying for something a little more in Gung Ho. He wants to make a statement about whining, complaining, often lazy American workers as compared to the Japanese. And he gets great performances from Michael Keaton, from Gedi Watanabe, who you just saw in the scene, and Chicago's own George Wendt. He has a hilarious start to the film, preaches just a little too hard, and then gives us a well-photographed but unbelievable Hollywood ending that solves few of the problems between Japanese management and American workers. Somehow, Ron Howard creates a film that is better than its parts. Norman's mark, a B. For the most part, Opie's view of the American workers worked. Richard Christiansen is up next with his review of the Pulitzer Prize-winning play Night Mother. Stay with us.
Thoughtful, I guess. What?
Don't Miss is being sponsored in part by your Chicagoland and Northern Indiana Buick dealers, Roto-Rooter, Dominick's Finer Foods, and Kelly-Kean Nissan Datsun.
Remember the great American Coupe? A sporty, full-size car that was fun to drive? Well, it's back. Introducing the 1986 Buick LeSabre Coupe. Sleek, luxurious, totally new, and sticker priced from as low as $12,511. Plus, get 9.9% financing on both LeSabre Coupe and LeSabre 4-door. See your Chicagoland, Northern Indiana Better Buick dealer and discover a full-size car that remembers when driving was fun.
Hi, I'm your new plumber. Yep, your old friend Roto-Rooter. Sure, Roto-Rooter is famous for cleaning drains and sewers, and now we can solve any plumbing problem day or night. Leaky faucets, clogged pipes, installation, repair. For fast, guaranteed plumbing service from the name you trust, call Roto-Rooter. There's only one. Same fast service for any plumbing problem.
Call Roto-Rooter, that's the name. There's only one.
At most food stores, the only fish you can buy is fresh from the deep freeze. But at Dominick's, you can also get fish fresh from the deep seas. Because Dominick's Neptune's Cove buys fresh fish and seafood daily for a never-frozen taste you're sure to get hooked on. Our cove captains will get your fish pan-ready, offer cooking suggestions, even recipes. So for great-tasting fish and seafood, come to Dominick's, because we've got the jump on fresh.
Who can help you drive home your dream car today? Kelly-Kean can, Kelly-Kean can. Who can sell you Nissan at a price you want to pay? Kelly-Kean can, Kelly-Kean can. For Nissan cars and Nissan trucks, shop Kelly-Kean and you'll save more bucks. Got a big selection, great service too, and a staff that'll go all out for you. The deals on the wheels with the most appeal. Remember Kelly-Kean, Kelly-Kean, Kelly-Kean can.
Theatergoers have two Pulitzer Prize winning plays to choose from right now. There's David Mamet's Glengarry Glen Ross, still at the Blackstone. And there's Marsha Norman's play about the tormented lives of a mother and daughter. Now, it's called Night Mother, and it's at Wisdom Bridge Theater. Richard Christiansen, entertainment editor for the Chicago Tribune, is here to give us his impressions of the play. And I take it that the production was good, but maybe the play wasn't so good.
Well, Norman, I'm disturbed by the script, but pleased with the production of Night Mother that's now playing at Wisdom Bridge Theater. Marsha Norman's play, which I grant you is impeccably crafted, sets up its situation very quickly in the first 5 minutes. A middle-aged, frumpy woman tells her somewhat dim-witted mother that she, that is the daughter, is going to commit suicide that night.
You talk to Agnes.
And then,
today?
For the rest of the play's 90 minutes, the two women go through an emotional love-hate tug of war as they confront the demons that have haunted their relationship through the years.
Now, how is she?
To the playwright's credit, she keeps the situation tense and involving to the end, leavening the drama with humor and inserting bits of homely activity, such as the making of a cup of cocoa, into the philosophical debates.
Mother. I'm serious. Agnes Fletcher's burned down every house she ever lived in. 8 fires. And she's due for a new one any day now.
No.
But despite all the careful rationalization and explanation, I do find it hard to believe that the cool, controlled, totally together woman I see on that stage is the same one who says her life is falling apart, that she can't control it anymore, and that therefore she has to end it. The play, for me, is a clever, manipulative exercise brought off neatly, but basically false. The Wisdom Bridge version, however, nearly makes it real. Doug Finlayson's direction charts the ebb and flow of passion precisely, and the two actresses are wonderful. Elizabeth Moore is the whiny, slovenly, small-minded mother to perfection, and Sarah Jane Avedon, her slight frame encased in an oversized sweater, exactly embodies the sense of defeat and frustration of her character. In short, Norman, the play is greatly helped by the production, which is terrific.
Now, it's a Pulitzer Prize-winning play, and I know from covering the Oscars that very often the wrong film wins. How important is a Pulitzer to a play, and do the same rules apply?
A Pulitzer means a lot, but not so much at the box office as a Tony Award does, mm-hmm. by the way. Tony always means more because it's on television.
Yeah.
And the Pulitzer Prize, you're right, is not always given to the best play, but it's kind of a middle-of-the-road play. I would say that 3 times out of 4 you get the right choice, though.
And this time?
Well, there it may or may not have been anything better around. Who mm-hmm. knows? I'm not a great fan of the play, but there are many people who think it's a wonderful work.
Thank you, Dick.
Sure.
Thank you. Easter means spring is here, and part of the celebration is egg dyeing. If you're looking for some decorative ideas, may we suggest the demonstration at the Chicago Historical Society this Thursday from 10 a.m. until noon. And while we're talking about the Historical Society, we'd like to correct something. The Motion Picture Palace's exhibition runs through June 1st. Now, last week we said it closed on March 15th, so you still have some time to see it. Begorra, lads and lasses, break out the shillelaghs. It's that time of the year when everyone is Irish, except this person and his accent. In the spirit of things, don't miss, went to the Sauganash to see the Sheila Tully Dancers.
One and up and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1.
Learning the Irish jig is no easy feat. To get a step up on things, parents send their children to classes when they're just wee ones. The youngest dancer in this group is 5 years old.
It's really fun. My favorite part is learning the new things.
Well, it's kind of fun, like the way you do it, like the
the way you move your legs and stuff. It's kind of neat.
You meet people. You go around. Dancing, it's fun.
It's more than just fun, though. Learning the traditional dances of Ireland also instills, early on in these children, a spirit, a sense of heritage that will again be passed down to another generation. First, though, the children master a variety of steps and progress in their ability to perform. Not only are these three girls in still another costume, they're champion dancers performing all over the country, and everyone thinks the time and the effort is worth it.
After a year of taking Irish dancing lessons, the children can go and perform. I think that that's what makes Irish dancing so much fun. And the basic four dances are the jig, the reel, the slip jig, and the hornpipe. And then we go into more intricate dances, which are called set pieces.
As far as St. Patrick's Day goes, we wondered if the saying was true, that on St. Patty's Day, everyone has a bit of the blarney in them, and even without lessons, would still be able to do the jig.
Anybody can learn it on St. Patrick's Day.
Now, did I say the Sauganash? It's Sauganash, a really nice Chicago Northwest Side neighborhood. The Tully School of Irish Dance has classes in both the city and the suburbs. Students will be stepping out tomorrow in the St. Patrick's Day parade, which I'll be joining. Hanging out the soiled family linen for a buck began with Christina Crawford.